Please welcome Susan Cain. Welcome.
Thank you.
You've been watching from backstage, right?
Yes.
So you've seen him?
Yes.
And he's not an example of an introverted person, right?
He is not. No, he is. Just as he's saying, he's exactly the opposite, I would say. Yeah. And, you know, and I really do think of this as a spectrum. So there's introvert here and extrovert here, yeah. And then there's everybody who's in the middle. And I think you're probably at the farther extreme of extrovert.
10 out of 10.
Yeah, maybe something like that. I don't know.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Well, but you are not. You are introvert.
I'm an introvert, yes.
So
yes.
Tell me, try to define the difference.
You know, I think a really quick definition that people can use is, how do you feel after you've been at a party? Let's say it's about 2 hours at the party. You're having a great time. You're with people whose company you truly enjoy. Mm. And how do you feel at the end of the 2 hours? Because if you're an extrovert, you're probably, you know, feeling very energized by that. You're wanting more. And if you're an introvert, you know, you might be very socially skilled. You might be with your best friends in the world. But you start to just hit a wall where, you know, you just want to chill out.
How is it for you to be here?
Well, I mean, I really love people. I love talking to people. I'm actually really comfortable in one-on-one and smaller conversations. So all of that is great. But it is true, you know, at the end of a day of doing interviews like this, I would definitely, like, consciously schedule into my calendar the time where I'm going to go get a cup of coffee by myself or something like that. And I really need to be deliberate about it.
See, I've seen that, like, with my sister. She's different to me because she's more introverted as well. And she just needs... Like, you just need that little kind of break, just a little escape for a while.
Yeah.
So I know, it's just kind of, it's different. Whereas for me, I kind of feed off of it.
Right,
so you see that kind of difference.
And how do you feel if you have a lot of time in solitude? Do you start to get antsy
comfortable? I feel like I need to talk to someone.
Right, right.
Yeah. Definitely, yeah.
Can you change through life? Can you be an extrovert like him? And then can he become an introvert later in life?
Well, it's funny because the studies show, and people talk about this, that everybody does tend to get more introverted as they get older. They all kind of mellow out a little bit. And we all also just develop all kinds of skills as we grow. So I'm guessing you're going to develop the skill of being comfortable in your solitude. And many introverts develop the skill of being comfortable in a room full of strangers. So you know, you kind of layer all these skills onto who you started out being, and then it turns into a new mishmash all its own. But there's some way in which we are fundamentally ourselves, I believe. And I think that the quickest way to get at that is to ask yourself to imagine, let's say, a weekend where you have no social, no professional obligations, and think about how would you want to spend your time when you really have free rein.
But I was curious about what you write, because you write that Western society favors extrovert people. Mm-hmm. How come is that?
Well, you know, it's funny. It was not always true. So in the 19th century, we had in Western society what historians call a culture of character, which had much more to do with valuing people's interior, you know, moral compass. But that was when we all lived in smaller towns and people lived alongside others that they had known all their lives. Then suddenly you have the 20th century and everybody's moving into the cities. They're suddenly having to vie for jobs in companies. There's movies and actors who are projected, you know, larger than life. And suddenly we entered what they call the culture of personality. And that's when we got into this state of really kind of affirmatively favoring one style over the other.
If you were to see people as leaders and followers, who would be the leaders and who would be the followers?
Well, that's actually one of the great myths, because I think that if you ask most people that question and they were answering honestly, they would tell you that they would see extroverts as natural leaders. And that's can be true for all the kind of obvious reasons. But when you look at a lot of studies at actual performance of actual leaders on the ground, you find that introverted leaders often deliver outcomes that are as good or in some cases better than extroverted leaders. So there really is room for different styles of leadership. Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah. You don't have to go far. I mean, you look at Silicon Valley, you know, so many of the leaders of Silicon Valley companies are introverts, and they're often kind of grown-up versions of children who are very passionate about one or two or three things in their lives, which is characteristic of introverts. In this case, it's technology. And, you know, in the service of these passions, people will grow up and inspire other people and have all kinds of expertise, and they really grow into those leadership positions, and they end up doing great.
Before you wrote your book, you're a lawyer. You used to be a Wall Street lawyer.
Yes.
So, as it's now 10 years since the finance crisis.
Yes.
Whose fault was it, the introverts or the extroverts?
I don't think that's the right way to look at it, the right way to frame the question. I think really the question is, what fault was there in the culture? And so what I would say is, in the years leading up to that financial crisis, we had a culture, and we still have it now, that favors risk takers, favors people who are going to be kind of out there and not necessarily thinking, what if this thing goes wrong? What about that potential concern? And if you have a culture that's only favoring one style of evaluating risk and not favoring the other alongside it, that's when you get into trouble.
I'm thinking about the kids here, because I understood that you were a quiet kid.
Yes.
And I've seen parents having quiet kids. We weren't. but having quiet kids and almost being ashamed of it, or almost being like, you got to say something now. Please say something now. Yeah. Because it's like the norm that they should be extroverted, but they aren't.
Yeah.
Are you seeing the same thing?
Oh, I do see that quite a bit. Not always, but quite a bit. And I mean, well, there's so much I'd want to say to those parents. But one thing is, whatever you feel in your heart about your child, whether you say it or not, it's going to communicate itself to your child. Mm-hmm. So if you're having those kinds of feelings, you need to really think it through and really see the kind of magical qualities that often go along with a quieter and more sensitive temperament, because there is a magic there. And if you're constantly saying to your child, speak up, speak up, like, they're getting the message that there's something wrong with who they are, as opposed to saying, yeah, you know, it would really make Aunt Sophie feel good if you said hello to her, and I know that's uncomfortable for you right now. Let me tell you what I do when I'm feeling uncomfortable. Here's my strategy. And we're going to practice that, and maybe if you're able to do that next time, we'll go for ice cream. You know, and so you're making it something that's acceptable and warm and affirmative. It's very different.
But I think even in school, it's very encouraged to sort of speak up and sit together and be in groups and working groups.
That is happening, but I will say, just as we're seeing changes with companies now, we're also seeing changes with schools. I've seen so many schools and so many educators really understand that there's a quiet revolution happening now and really changing the way they think about how to teach the introverts and the extroverts.
Let that be a final word. Thank you so much, Susan Cain.
You're so welcome.
Hope you enjoyed the clip. For more interesting conversations, please hit subscribe.